Oh, what a year. Oh, what a year. The year 2020. We came into this year with excitement about the prospect of seeing the glory of God in the year 2020. The prospect of businesses doing well, like any businessman or woman will expect as they move into a new year. The prospect of healthy families and marriages. The prospect of career and education getting to the next level. The prospect of seeing the glory of God in our churches. But then the unexpected happened. A global pandemic hit. A pandemic that shifted the axis of the course of this world. Here in the US alone, we have recorded over 230,000 deaths, with an average of 85,000 cases per day, with the worldwide cases of over 1.2 million deaths, not to mention the millions that were affected by this pandemic. Think about the fear and the panic that was spreading like wildfire. And in the midst of this, the social unrest and racial divide in our cities, nations, countries, and around the world. And this has caused a severe ripple effect that it caused the shutdown of businesses, the shutdown of schools, the shutdown of churches, and a global shutdown. I can't begin to tell you the impact of these shutdowns on human life. It had led to a dramatic loss of human life worldwide, an unprecedented challenge to public life, food systems, and businesses. This economic and social disruption had caused tens of millions of people to fall into extreme poverty. Without the means to earn an income during these shutdowns, many are unable to feed themselves and their families. Time will not permit me to talk about border closures, trade restrictions, and confinement measures that have been preventing farmers from accessing markets and agricultural workers from harvesting crops. And this has disrupted domestic and international food chains to and from other countries. And on top of that, the fellowship and the love among the brethren and even among the clergy in the house of God has been broken because of all the restrictions and the measures that are in place. So what we did was we started praying as a church, because that's the only thing we know to do, to call on God. But the more we called on God, the more it felt like God was silent. The more we cried out in prayer, the more it felt like God wasn't even listening. And it felt like what the prophet Jeremiah saw in Jeremiah 31 verse 8, when he said, God watched silently as the nation of Israel was uprooted, torn down, overthrown, destroyed, and afflicted. Oh yes, we cried for change. The more we cried, the more we were broken. Why are we crying to God and it feels like we are being broken even the more? Why are we crying and on every side we are experiencing brokenness? But hear me, someone, brokenness precedes an awakening. Hear me again, brokenness precedes an awakening. For the Bible says in John 12:24, unless a seed of grain falls and dies, it stays alone, but when it dies, it brings forth much fruit. Sometimes God will let you fall on your face. Sometimes God will let you die to your flesh as a sign of brokenness, in order to experience the awakening that he has for you. There is a reason why God breaks us. Brokenness is when God stops us, when God holds our progress and causes us to see the end to which we will come if we continue down the same road. Brokenness is a place when God crushes us under the weight of our own sins and disobedience. That is why David teaches us in Psalm 51 verse 7 and 8 that God crushes and breaks us in order to save us, when he said, purge me with hyssop and I shall be purged, wash me and I shall be whiter than snow, make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Ladies and gentlemen, upon this premise, the Lord has placed a demand on me to call a solemn assembly of the body of Christ at the beginning of this coming year for a 21 days fasting and prayer, starting from January 1st to the 21st, 2021, here at Calvary Redemption Center, 7 p.m. each night. And I believe that as we gather together to pray from the place of brokenness, there shall be an awakening. Will you join me as we pray to see an awakening in our churches, in our homes, in our businesses, in our economy, in our country?